Now, I didn't immediately withdraw a new Pokémon, because we are about to get an encounter, and I was thinking of maybe just seeing what that is, putting that on the team instead, if it's something good enough. If not, we'd probably bring back our starter. It's an Ekans. Okay, yeah. I mean, we already have three poison types on the team. We're not using and Ekans with this current team. Oh, come on. And of course, right as that happens, it uses Rap, so I can't switch to one of my Pokémon that has Hypnosis. We're just gonna keep throwing Pokeballs at it till it stays in. Okay, now while normally I would go with like a two-stage evolution line, I can't pass this up. The whole, four kids era Arbok evolves into Sviper bit is too good to leave aside. So, let's go into Azalea, put our new Pokemon in the PC, and bring someone else out. Saying that, I didn't necessarily think that it was going to be a permanent part of the team, but still disappointing. And he did come through for us in some pretty big, I had forgotten that I even had the Hoppip. I was thinking that Sandshrew and Totodile were the only options. I mean, I love Sandshrew, and we do already have a water type, just like we already have a ground type. But it is a slightly higher level, and it's our starter. I mean, we're putting him at the front of the party because he has fallen behind the rest of the party. It's not much behind Zubat. And no, I'm not referring to them by their nicknames. Nickname gimmick, it's fun, but it could get too confusing. level are his Pokemon? Level 9. That's not that far behind. Yes, but why chance anything? I mean, especially after I was... I mean, after seeing how little my attack did, I was about to switch into Ghastly any... Oh, shoot. I'm so used to walling out normal types that I forgot I still don't have a move that can hit normal types on this one. Which means I'm splitting the XP further. Should have just gone straight for scratch. Okay, that actually does a significant chunk. Oh, but so does that. Feels kind of risky staying in, but... Okay, I was going to say, I'm potioning up after this, but... We also do get an encounter in here, but so far, I haven't actually... I think the encounter rate in here is fairly low. It actually is entirely possible that we'll get through this segment without actually encountering anything. It's a little risky staying in because I'm confused. Oh, never mind, I'm not confused. Now, it's no longer even the lowest level member of the team. Oh wait, it says rap, so... I was going to do this to be, like, safe, but it's not actually that all that safe. This should be fine. Completely immune to rap. It has a poison type move. And we actually can successfully hit this. Not doing much, but it won't be doing much to me either. Only one damage. Crit and Paralysis. Nice. Using my flying type right before the flying type, right before the bug type gym. It's kinda devastating. Not gonna lie. I mean, I do still have a flying type, but it's not gonna learn any flying type moves until much higher level. This is the aforementioned. I mean, defensively, Zubat's still gonna be a beast in the bug gym. Quad resists bug type. Any of them that have poison type moves, we're gonna resist that. Actually knows a rock type move. I'm really not that poor off for the bug gym anyway. I was thinking, like, I just lost my flying type that was about to learn a flying type move. I don't have a fire type because I didn't want a chance only getting a Pidgey instead of a Growlithe when I still had the move. Get our level ups on our Zubat soon enough. Actually, I am going to switch train a little bit. Because Dewdew just handles this so well. Oh, and it really was right on the verge of level up. I'm not even worried about this, because, like, even if I hit myself, you can't crit yourself on confusion. And Zubat just does so little damage to me. Thank you. thought about potioning up my Geodude, but then I remembered Skype only has a single coffin. Which means that he's pretty much free. I mean, I think by this level it should have a poison-type move, but that's still going to do next to nothing. I mean, just to be safe, I'm just going to put it to sleep, but I just shouldn't even need that. This isn't going to be fast, because even Stab, Lick is a weak move, and Ghastly has poor physical attack. Oh god, that really is doing, like, nothing, but... best thing it could possibly have is Small, which is a very weak move. Not even a very accurate move. And, we resist it. I think Quag resists even. Yeah, it does have Smog. I figured it would, but that's gonna do one damage. What? Oh, crit. Okay, but if crit did 4, that means it's actually doing 2. Damage. Maybe we only regular resist it? Well, like I said, it's also not terribly accurate, so... I mean, I'll admit, the Smog did more than I thought it would, but it's still not going to do... not doing nearly enough for me to feel threatened by it. Oh, and that's my third crit lick this battle. One more should finish this off. Okay, we get the lure ball. We could have actually had a fishing rod by now, but I passed it up. Because I forgot about it until a little too late, but it's just the old rod, it's no big deal. Wait, how many should I use? That was a crystal change, not a heart, gold, soul, silver change as well? Let me just double check. I'm pretty sure I'm all healed up. Yeah, I am. But I wasn't quite sure. Okay, let's get our encounter in here. Because we didn't actually get one. Because the encounter rate is so low. Maybe I should wait until I can get through and rappel over to the lower floor? No. I want an encounter now. See, we could wait until we have strength and get an encounter on the lower floor, but nope, we're gonna grab this. Well, we're not going to grab that because it's a repeat. Wait. Let me actually just... well, no, there should be Slowpoke in here, but... do I even want a Slowpoke? I already have 2 water types on my team now. Psychic type is nice. Yeah, I'm gonna look up, encounters for Slowpoke while... Yeah, it's just Zubat and Slowpoke in here. I was gonna say if I had the fishing rod, but no, I'd have an 85% chance of Magikarp. I wait until I can go to the lower floor. There's still not much in here. Like, it would just be, yeah, Zubat and Golbat, Goldeen, Line, and Magikarp on fishing. Okay, yeah, it actually doesn't necessarily pay to wait, because unless I want to, like, because there's not enough variety, if anything. Either way, I'd be getting a water type in here, because the only non-water type is Zubat, which I already have. Percent Zubats, 15% Slowpokes. Might have been better if I had just grabbed the old rod and gotten them. Magikarp or something here. Yeah, except a lot of the towns only have fishing encounters. The reason I'm really staying at this is because I'm not writing things down, so like I feel like I might forget to come back here if I don't get my encounter here now. Come on, Slowpoke. Nope, it's just another Zubat. Checking exactly what Slowpoke's level up move progression is. Oh my god, it doesn't. Starts with Curse and Tackle and gets Growl at level 6, and then Water Gun at 15, Confusion at 20. It would be pretty much useless for quite some time. We're leaving. We're leaving. And yes, I'm going to fight every trainer in the gym. That I'm going to do for every gym. I mean, if I skip trainers out on the routes, I can always come back. Okay, this would only be... Oh no, this would be resisted. I mean, I'd resist them, but... Really... Really is frustrating that it takes so long for Zubat to learn a move stronger than Leech Life. Non-stab Leech Life. When is Zubat's next move? I feel like it's learning it soon. But I don't think it's a terribly strong move. Oh, actually, it is a strong move. Learns Bite at level 12. Paralyzed it. Oh, it's going to just keep spamming supersonic because it has it only has normal type attacking moves. Oh, and nope, now it is actually using the tackle. How did I do that much damage to myself? Oh, right. I was like, when my attack is that bad, but then I was like, oh, right. My defense is also that bad, isn't it? Bug does not resist bug, but also not resistant to it has attack on it, it's only attacking. Which I don't resist. Well, we'll see what happens here. It's faster? Didn't string shot me, did it? No. No, I outspit, so it must be a speed tie. Yeah, it's a speed tie. Feels like that's been happening way too much in this Nuzlocke. See how much damage it was gonna do to me. Not much, and that was a crit. That didn't look like it did any more than my regular hits were. Well, I guess it did because I did heal 2 off of the crit and only 1 off of my regular hits. I must be doing like 3 damage, because it looks like I'm doing a lot more. Right. It's a speed tie. That shouldn't have been able to knock me out even if it didn't crit. In the start and then switch to over. Mm-hmm. set speed, that's not that surprising. Geodude is very slow. And yet it's been doing nothing but string shot. I guess Poison Sting is quad resisted, but still, that's its only attack move. So it's not like it's deprioritizing it to, because there are better moves. Went to turn on some lights in this room, and I took my headphones off, and yeah, it's also raining. It is very much raining and thundering where I live. Like, when I saw this, I'm like, and this is where I wish I still had a flying type. But then I remembered, wait, this is going to be weak to bug type. But then I remembered, pretty sure at this point it wouldn't have any attacking moves it can hit. I was like, it should have Sun Spore by now, but it shouldn't actually have any direct attacking moves it can hit. Gas Space though, this should still be pretty safe. Happened to still have Zubat's page open because of the whole looking at what it learns. It's actually the only thing in my party that can learn it. But yeah. Not stab, but it is 3 times the base power of Leech Life. And resisted by a lot fewer things. That is so nice to see. wanted this to go quicker, I'd just send it Poliwag to the water move. Which probably isn't a horrible idea. Split a little more experience, but I mean, this already is enough to get it to level 12 easily. Even split it would have been no question. Oh. Drill next, okay. Guess I have to take this one seriously. That's gonna be a level up. And now after actually having moved ahead at one point, our starter is once again our lowest level, so that's what we're going to lead off with, just for a bit. EXP. Yeah, that's what I thought. In the remake, he leads with the Scyther, I guess, to show off the whole, U-turn. But that's doing nothing. That's doing nothing. We are going to go into our not only special attack, but we do also have the grass type. But we're not using the grass type. That still doesn't do much though. I shouldn't really been doing that all. Just running over this gym with my rock type again. Teodude is just so good in the early game. Rock-type moves to take down the first gym. Rock-type moves to take down the second gym. Resists normal and rock-type moves for the third gym. And it needs a mill tank. To be honest, I'm not going to send it out against Puffery just because it does have 2 4-times weaknesses and that Puffery has metronome. But yeah, against the killer Miltank, this is my counter. Already 3 damage. We're not in any danger unless we got like a whole lot of misses. Okay, and this time we actually did level up twice. And got a ground type move. That's actually a second possible answer for the rivals Ghastly in this next fight. That was the real reason that I wanted to make sure to get Zubat to level 12, because I knew we were coming up with a fight against Ghost type. We could have taught what's that, but no, really that many great things to teach to. I don't think Fury Cutter is really that useful. Slightly better on physical attack than special attack, even though, with the miracle seed, like, and of course, stab. I mean, grass is definitely its better move to be attacking with, and, like, once it gets poison type, moves that too, but. Yeah, I'm not gonna teach you. Especially since I'm not reserving a slot for an HM mule the way some people do. I probably will, like, sort of, like, later in game, just, like, teach HM moves to some of the reserves. Actually, hold on, now I've gotta look something up. A lot of grass types can learn cut. Hoppip is not one of them. I was hoping I could just use that for my cut Pokemon, but. Okay, wait, did I already heal up the Poke Center? I did. Starting this game at 6? I feel like there's... Okay, the Ghastly's up first. We actually couldn't do a thing against that, so... Ghastly was fast, but Zubat's fast too. And it gets power. As long as it's not fully paralyzed, it's done its job. probably already has Bite, but we try Bite. Whatever, it's a flying type. Let's just... One turn, I'm worse off. One turn after I potion, I'm worse off than I was before because I took two bites and hit myself with confusion. Yeah, we're just going straight for another potion. We're not waiting. So much trouble for a Pokemon that we did eventually one-shot. Okay, I guess I'm sending Zubat back out. Bad as grass types are in Gen 2, I've noticed that like most challenge runners, like the single Pokemon challenge, if none of the starter types are actually like any better or worse off, like they'd all be neutral against something, they usually replace Totodile with whatever so that their starter gets so that their opponent, their rival, gets Bayleaf, because it actually is the toughest due to having, at least in the early game, due to having better moves. Let's see. Even super effective Leech Bite is not as strong as Neutral Swift. But it is healing. So maybe I should be. I mean, we know how much a crit does. We are safe for one more turn. Feels like it actually did more than a Swift did. Oh, that's right, Reflect was up. I should have just used Bite even though I'm more of a physical attacker. Heal 3 health. No, I'm still gonna potion. I was was thinking it might actually be safe to take one more, but... That's a high crit move, and it does a bunch. Swift should be the stronger option. It really does not feel like it has been. There's something weird going on. I know that each life only has a power of 20, and Swift has a power of 60, and they're both physical moves. So, I mean, why does it... It really seems as if the leech life is actually doing more. Go ahead for a little bit. I was debating whether to, Okay. Rage actually is weaker than Scratch, so this should be perfect. Okay, even with a crit, that was actually really perfect. There's so many bug and poison types to choose from. Let's see, in this game, for bug and poison types, I think it's just Beedrill and Venomoth. Oh, no wait, and the Spinarakwan. And for later games, there's the Scolipede one, and there is Dustox. And are there any others? I mean, there's no guarantee that I'm even going to get, like, all of the others. So let's just go with Dustox. And if we end up with a Beedrill line, we'll name that after the Scolipede line. I was thinking of maybe doing the, forfeit sequence now, but I think I'm gonna pause the stream. We used a lot of potions. Because we do still have some Pokemon that are a little weak, so I'm going to do 5 and 5. I'm not going to just only buy super potions at this point. I mean, like, take, for example, Zubat. It's got in the low 30s in HP, last I checked.